Hello friends, this video on metals and non-metals part 2 is brought to you by examfear.com. No more fear from exam. Let us look at some of the common metals. So the first common metal I would say is gold. You would have seen it in the gold jewelry, your finger rings, earrings or pendant, necklaces, bangles. So that's gold. Silver also, again, you see mostly in anklets, chains, lot of jewelries, lot of, sometimes people also use silver utensils or silver materials in temples. Copper, zinc. So this slide is basically to make you acquainted with the look of each of these metals. Like if you look at gold, the color is very shiny and yellowish. Look at silver, it is like the color is grayish, but again it has a lot of shine. So each of these metals, if you look at iron, it is more blackish and the shine is there, but obviously the shine is not that much as it is in case of gold or silver. You see sodium, magnesium, potassium, calcium, cobalt and nickel. So in this slide you actually get to see how exactly each of these metals look like. Now, these are the most commonly used metals. I mean, they find a lot of applications everywhere. In fact, you can actually find gold, silver, iron, copper, aluminium, all these metals, you will find it in your house itself. So these are like most common metals. So now the question is, what are metals? Now, how do we know or how do we define a metal? What is that basic thing? Because you will see that when we start talking about the properties, we will see that there are a lot of properties to which there are exceptions. So they are not true for all metals. So what is that basic thing which defines that this object is going to be a metal and this one is going to be a non-metal? So metals are those substances which are electropositive in nature. Now, what do I mean by electropositive? I'll explain. So these metals always have a tendency to lose electrons. Now, do you remember in one of our previous lessons, I spoke about electrons, protons and neutrons. Now, whatever object we see around us, what are they? They are all matter, and matter is made up of molecules. Molecules are made up of atoms, right? So anything that we see around us is matter. Matter is made up of molecules. Molecules are made up of atoms. And what do we have inside an atom? Now, inside the atom, we have three types of particles, that is protons, neutrons, and electrons. Now, protons are the positively charged particles, electrons are the negatively charged particles, and neutrons are neutral. So, if you look at the structure of an atom, so this is how roughly the structure of atom would look like. So, here the protons and the neutrons, they are not mobile, so they are concentrated towards the center of the atom. So this is like the structure of one atom. So towards the center, you have the protons and the neutrons. So the red and the blue balls represent protons and neutrons. Whereas electrons are mobile. So these are electrons. So how do they move? They keep moving in orbits. So they are like moving in orbits around the protons and neutrons. So the protons and neutrons are present together, and this central portion of the atom is termed as the nucleus. So nucleus contains protons and neutrons, and electrons are moving. They are moving in orbits around the nucleus. Clear? So that is how the structure of atom roughly is. Now, metals are those substances which always have tendency to lose electrons. So these electrons which are present, they always tend to lose electrons. Now, if a substance is losing an electron, what will happen to that substance? Electron is negatively charged. So basically, that substance is losing some negatively charged particle. So what will happen? The number of positively charged particle in that substance will be more. So the substance will become electropositive. Let me try to explain it in this way. So let us suppose this is your atom. So just forget the fact where the electrons are, where the protons are. Just consider this orange ball is your atom. Inside this atom, you have protons, you have electrons, you also have neutrons. So right now, since I am talking about the charges, I am not talking about neutrons because neutrons are anyways neutral. Now in this case, in case of metals, what happens is, now right now, if you see the number of protons and the number of electrons are equal. So you see the blue balls are also 4 and the gray balls are also 4. So that means the number of positively charged particle is also 4, number of negatively charged particle is also 4. So overall the atom is neutral. Now what will happen if this atom loses one electron? So the gray balls were electrons. So one electron is gone. Now what happens to this atom? So if you see now it has 4 positively charged particles. The blue ones are positively charged particles. And how many negatively charged particles? Only 3. So overall this atom is now positively charged. Right? So these kind of substances which always have a tendency to lose electrons and become positive, these kind of substances are metals. Now you might have a question in your mind that which kind of substances will have tendency to lose electrons. Well, to understand that, you actually need to understand the electronic configuration. You need to understand how electrons are arranged in an atom. Now we are not discussing that part at this level, but as you go to your higher classes, when you know about the electron configuration, then you will get to understand that which type of elements have a tendency to lose electrons. But for now, you should understand that anything which has a tendency to lose electrons, they are metals. So all the metals which we are talking about, whether it is sodium, whether it is potassium, whether it is iron, magnesium, aluminium, so they all have a tendency to lose electrons. So let me take an example of, say, sodium. So what happens to sodium? Now sodium loses one electron and becomes what? Now once it loses one electron, it becomes Na+. So it acquires this positive charge because it has released one electron. So that is the tendency of metals, and that is how they have been categorized as metals. So this is the basic definition. This is the basic way by which we define metals. So examples are sodium, iron, copper, gold, silver, aluminium. So you name any metal and this property of metal will hold true for them because this is the basic way by which they have been defined as metals.
Thank you. Please visit www.examfeo.com to watch more educational videos with a better experience. Please do not forget to like and subscribe to our YouTube channel for latest updates. Thank you once again.